things are growing like crazy. Oh yeah, and guess what? We have a little tomato. A little tomato in there. Hello everybody and welcome back to the garden. No hat today, I'm taking my chances. So hopefully I won't get sapped on. So we have a little issue out here. Maybe a week ago, we saw a rat on our deck because we just live with trees everywhere, right? And they live in the oak trees and stuff. Well, a couple days ago, we trimmed back this sea orchid so that it's not all these, see these, how these grow literally long like this? From the second story, by the way. Well, they were like coming all the way over here. And so there was a little like rodent highway because they live back in the sea orchids, you know. So I think that a little rat was responsible for eating the little tiny lettuce seedlings that I had. And also we have squirrels, which we have squirrel families that we have on our deck, and so we don't want to get rid of them. And so what I've decided to do today is build a couple cages for the earth boxes that have just the new germination seedlings in there. Germinated seedlings, can't talk today. What else is new? And so I went to Ace Hardware and got some hardware cloth, some zip ties because I don't feel like dealing with C-clamps. Got my sheet to lay out, annealer. The most important thing is reverse coaster to cover my coffee so it doesn't get leaves in it. Snipper and some gloves. So I'm gonna build me some cages. Okay, so a little update. I brought this operation inside just because it was so windy out there and it just was not easy to work. So you can really tell this, but this piece of hardware cloth that I got in the package was not quite long enough because the earth box all the way around, I would need 78 inches. And the roll is only a 5-foot roll. So I had to fold. I started at one end. Sorry, I started at this end. Folded it 1 foot, 27 inches, 1 foot. And then whatever was left here, I went out and bought two more rolls, cut the piece the length that I needed, that I was missing. Then what I've done now is I've taken the corner because I wanted a really clean corner. And I've zip tied the corners. Of course, there we go. I've zip tied the corners, you know, the edge of the one side. And I'm gonna zip tie the place in the middle and I'll just put that towards the back. And then when I'm totally sure that, you know, I'm ready to put this up, well, I'm gonna snip those off anyway because you can't really reverse them out of there anyway. So that's where I am right now. So I'm going to finish constructing like the actual shell and then I'm going to put I'll stand it up. So that's how high it's going to be. Can you see that? I think it's like 36 inches high or whatever. And then I will put a top on it and then we'll take it back outside. Okay, so I think this is going to work. Put a zip tie there just to hold it. I've stood it up. And I've kind of, you know, bent it to be where it's pretty rectangular because, you know, it comes in that roll and you have to, as you unroll it, you have to kind of bend it in the opposite direction. By the way, this is the reason why I did not buy poultry cloth, because poultry cloth is really difficult to get a bend in since they're a little like octagonal shapes or something. So I opted for the ones with the squares. My poor vegetables are gonna be in jail to protect them. Okay, so the outside perimeter of the cage is complete. Obviously one end will be open because it'll be sitting on top of the earth box. I'm now making the lid on top So I've measured that to be just like an inch or two over, so I have some room to play in case these, sometimes these wires break out of the line, so I want some extra. And I'm just in the process now of cutting this little extra off, and I will attach it to the top. Okay, this is going on pretty well. Keep in mind all these zip ties will be gone. So I'm doing the edge, and I'm trying to get the, you know, the front edge super clean. And then the one that's in the back here can be, you know, not so great. But I'm trying to get the front edges really clean. Yeah, I think this is going to work. Okay, almost completed now. I just have to snip off these ties. But, yeah, it doesn't even look that bad as far as evenness. So I snip off the ties. Yeah, not too bad for my first attempt at this. And then we'll go out in the garden and put it on the earth box. Okay, all the zip ties are now off. And yeah, ready to take this outside. We went and met a friend for coffee, and so now I'm back. And we're gonna take this outside and put it on. Okay, so this turned out way better than I expected for my first try at this. And I was actually able to bend this in a way that I could get the watering tube on the outside. And literally, I can't barely even put my pinky finger in here. So I know no squirrel is gonna get in right there. And I've staked these in with these, see those landscaping timber things? I've put them in there. And I've kind of wedged it in there. I could have maybe made this just slightly smaller. So if I, well, I have to do another one for this earth box because the lettuce leaves, they're not quite to the top of that yet. Like I still have, it probably looks like they're touching in the video, but they're actually not. They're like at least an inch and a half away. But yeah, so now the watering tube's on the outside. And I'm going to push that back in once I move that other earth box over so I don't damage any tomatoes. But this will allow them to grow, and that's quite tall. I mean, okay, that's almost level, maybe a little bit, tiny bit higher than our railing. So if I walk on our deck a little bit more, you can see how tall that is. And that will allow those plants to grow really well. And so the next thing I'll probably do, and I possibly could have done this before I put that on, is I need to thin those seeds, but I will deal with that tomorrow. And hopefully tomorrow I'll be making the other one, but I have to go get some more materials. So yeah, I'm not terribly disappointed with how that turned out, and I would highly recommend making one of these for your earth box. Again, I would maybe make it just a slightly bit smaller, so that it was more even on the edges, but I don't think any squirrel is going to be able to topple that, and I think it's going to be okay. So yeah, check back, and until next time, there we go. Things are really growing now. And by the way, these seeds that I started, look at, oh my goodness, they're actually, wow, they're taller than I thought they were. Yay! So I got a lot of the sunflowers going. Again, some of those other ones back over there were older seeds, so I wasn't even sure if those would be doing anything. And so far, the kale and broccoli hasn't come up yet, but the sunflowers have. So I'll have to take those out of there soon. Okay, guys, see you next time.